See there. This is a decision making symbol. Okay, this one is a decision making symbol. And as we discussed that, decision making symbol contain the three flow line. Okay, two is out from it. माने दीटा फ्लो लाइन आदरो आउट रहिवो ये देखो डिसीजन मेकिंग रे वन इज एस एंड अनदर इज नो इफ यू टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस प्रोसेसिंग सिंबल इट कंटेन द टू फ्लो लाइन वन कनेक्टिंग टू प्रीवियस अनदर कनेक्टिंग नेक्स्ट बट हियर वन कनेक्टिंग टू द प्रीवियस अनदर कनेक्टिंग टू द नेक्स्ट अनदर इट इज कंटेन नो पार्ट दैट इज अ डिसीजन बॉक्स सो डिसीजन बॉक्स कंटेन the three flow line where the other box contain only two flow line okay bujhela decision box ta kemti the next Just a minute. Okay, the flowchart should use the page connector if they extend over the multiple pages. The logic of the flowchart should be checked by testing the flowchart using some sample value. So after drawing the flowchart, you have to check that your logic is correct or not. For checking that, we are taking some sample value. Through the sample value, we have to verify that our logic is correct or not. So again, I discuss about the rules of the flowchart. Okay, so yesterday I discussed it. The entire logic of the flowchart should be represented using the standard symbol. So by using some standard symbol, you have to represent your logic, like for taking the input, for processing, for output, for starting and ending of the flowchart. So entire thing you have to represent in a flowchart symbol. Flowchart should be clear, precise, and easy to follow. The flowchart should have only one start point and only one end point. So every flowchart contains one start point and only one end point. The steps in the flowchart represented by the flowchart symbol. So every logic that you represent through a symbol. I mean, input box, output box, starting, ending. So everything is represented in the flowchart symbol. The necessary input should be listed in a logical order. The input, process, output, and display symbol should have at least two flow lines, but the decision box contains the three flow lines. Just mutam create example dekho dile that your decision box contains the three flow lines. Means decision box, one is connecting to the next previous, another it is having a yes or no. Okay, so there is a two option is present. So only exceptionally thing is present, like decision box contain three flow line or other symbol contain the two flow line. So it is a simple question. Okay, so you write it, then I will show the answer. Draw the flow chart. Draw the flowchart to accept the principal rate and time value and display the simple interest. Okay, so it is the answer. See that. Start input P, R, and T. First, take the principal rate and time. Then simple interest equals to P into R into T divided by 100. To find out the simple interest, first P into R into T divided by 100. Then display the simple interest, then end. So it is a flow chart, start, input, take the principal, take the rate, take the time. Simple interest equals to P into R into T divided by 100. So which is providing you simple interest.
Sir, what is simple interest?
Sometimes what happened, we are borrowing the money. Okay. Ame kon koru na tumi shunthibo je bank ru ame udhar aniwa on a credit. Okay. That means we pay it later. So when we take the money or we borrow the money from bank or any other resources, then again we supposed to be paid. Okay. So when you pay, you have to give some additional amount. Suppose I am giving you 100 rupees, then when you return me, you are not return me 100 rupees, you return it more. Okay, you return me as a 100 plus 10, 110. So that 10 rupees is called as the interest. Got it? That is a simple interest. And here principal is what? Principal means the amount I am giving you. So the amount is 100 rupees. So that is a principal amount. A rate means in which rate I am giving you interest. Okay, suppose I am giving you 100 rupees and I am telling you that 100 rupees when you return, it is having a 10% of interest. So 100 rupees, 10% is 10 rupees. Okay, so 100 plus 10. Okay, this 10 rupees you are giving for which timing? For 1 month. So I am telling you, Subhasri, you just take the 100 rupees and for you require 100 rupees, I am giving you, but I am asking you when you return. You are telling that I am returning you after 1 month. So yes, correct. But after 1 month, when you return, it will be charges you 10 rupees, mean 10%. So you return me 110. If you take another 1 month, then 2 months. When it is 2 months, then again another 10 rupees is added. Means you have to return me 120 rupees. So that amount is based upon your timing. When your timing is increases, similar way your interest is also increases. Clear? So that is called as the what? Simple interest. So that how to calculate the simple interest? For calculating the simple interest, the formula is P into R into T divided by 100. So P into R into T divided by 100. So that display the simple interest. Okay? Understood? Okay, so draw it. Over. So draw a flow chart that accepts a number and display its cube. Okay, so draw a flow chart that accepts a number and display its cube. Cube means
The number, we have to multiply the number 3 times.
Okay, so this question is for you. You do it and send me, okay? By using flowchart, okay?
Sir, your voice is cracking. Can you say it again?
It is a question, it is a homework for you, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, write that question and return me back. Okay. Okay, so next question is draw a flow chart that accepts a length and breadth of a rectangle and display its area and perimeter. Okay, so what is the area of rectangle?
Length into breadth.
And perimeter?
2 into length plus breadth.
Okay, good. So you write this question and draw it through a flowchart. Okay, so that is also a homework. Right, question. Then another question you write, take two number, draw a flow chart, accept two number, then multiply it and so the result. Next is, at times you need to check certain condition to decide further course of action. You often need to perform a lot of tasks a number of times repeatedly. The flowchart allow you to represent the condition and repetitive process. Okay, sometimes what happened, like we have to follow the instruction based upon the condition. Like if you want to delete a file from your mobile, if you are having a picture and you want to delete that picture, it is asking you, do you want to delete that photo? Yes and no. So it is asking you, it asks for your permission. If you give the permission, then your file is deleted. The similar way, when you write the program, you perform the task. So at times you need to check certain condition to decide further course of action. You often need to perform a lot of tasks a number of times repeatedly. The flowchart allow you to represent the condition and repetitive process. Okay. So it means what? Like flowchart allow you to represent condition and repetitive process. So that is called as what? Like you can say it is a flowchart is of three type. One is sequential, step-by-step process. Another is a decision-making. Another is repetitive process. So sometimes when you go for checking condition, we go for flowchart conditional statement. And when you want to repeat one statement more than one time, then we go for the repetitive process. So there is a two part for condition, conditional statement, and for repeated statement, repetitive process we are using. Now check here that we are using a conditional flowchart, like to find out which number is even and odd. Can you say how to find out the even and odd number? What is the even number? Tell me.
Even number, then the multiples of two.
You can say like when the number is divisible by two. When the number is divisible by two, it is called as an even number. Okay. Now check, it is a flowchart of taking an even number. The start, it is an input box, accept a number, then divide the number by two. It is a process box. In processing, we divide a number. Then the condition box has come. It will check or it is divide the number and check the remainder is equals to zero. If the remainder is equals to zero, it is showing you display the number is even. If the remainder is not zero, then display the number is odd. This is a display box. The first, it is divide the number. It is a processing box. Then it will check that is the number is equals to zero. If it is yes, display number is even. If it is no, display number is odd. Then end of your flowchart. Okay. Understood this one? This one is decision box. See that three flow line is present. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Draw it. Even or odd number.
Sir, complete.
So there is another question. Consider another example where the following remarks should be given to the students depending on the grade they have scored in the exam. Okay. If you pass grade A, it is excellent. Grade B, very good. Grade C is good. Okay, so consider a example where the following remarks should be given. If you pass grade A, excellent, grade B, very good, grade C, good. If there are any other grade entered by the user instead of A, B or C, the message invalid input should be displayed. So write the question.
Sir, from where I have to write? From considered.
You write the question. The remarks should be given, right? The remarks should be given.
The remarks should be given
to the students.
To the students.
Depending on the grade they have scored in the exam.
They have scored in the exam.
Grade A, excellent. Grade B, very good. Grade C, good. Okay, if any other grade is entered by the user instead of A, B or C,
so complete.
Now see the answer here. The first is stat, accept grade. Is, when you are giving a grade, it will check that is the grade is equals to A. If it is S, display excellent, then comes and here end. Then accept the grade B. If you are passing any other grade, A grade, no. Suppose I am passing B, S, then display very good, end. If I pass the grade C, first start, accept grade. Is your grade is equals to A? No. Is your grade is equals to B? No. Is your grade is equals to C? Yes. Then display good. If I pass, suppose E, start, accept the grade E. Is your grade is equals to A? No. Is your grade is equals to B? No. Is your grade is equals to C? No. Then display invalid input. Okay. So draw it. Over.
No, sir.
Next comes to the dry run table. Dry run table is what? So after draw your flow chart, you have to check that your logic is correct or not. After draw your flow chart, you have to check your logic is correctly written or not. For that, we take some sample value, okay, and verify that our logic is correct or not. Like after, when your mother is preparing a food, okay, sometimes she is giving you to taste it, whether it is good or not. Okay, the dry run is also like that. You have to taste that, or you have to analyze your flow chart is written correctly or not. So dry run help you to perform the logic check and understand the flow of your control. It can be used to evaluate the output of the program with the set of some sample value. So you have to take some sample value and check all your program is written correctly or not. It provided a step-by-step evaluation of the values in a program. So step-by-step, you have to evaluate it. So now I am showing you the dry run table to add first 10 natural number. Natural number means the number that you are counting, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we have to add that first 10 natural number and show the output. Now check here. Okay, so it is a dry run table. It is a flow chart to find out the sum of first 10 natural number. See there, it is a dry run table. First start. N is equals to 0. Okay, so now check, let sum is equals to 0. Sum is 0 now. Let N is equals to 0 and sum is equals to 0. Now, Suvasri, what happened?
Yes, sir.
Bujhu chata?
Yes, sir.
Dekha. Let n is equals to 0, sum is equals to 0. So here the first iteration has started. Iteration means repetition. N is equals to n plus 1. Iteration means we have to repeat. We are again back to this position. I mean, again, say part go back career. So there it is make in a red color, iteration one. So here our processing has start. N is equals to N plus N. So earlier N value is zero. So zero plus one is one. Now sum is equals to sum plus N. Sum value is zero. So zero plus one. Now sum is one here. So now the condition will check. Is n value is 10? Is 1 is equals to 10? No, 1 is not equals to 10. Then again, when it comes to again this position, then it is called the second iteration. Then it comes to here. That is a second iteration. In second iteration, iteration 2, n is equals to n plus 1. Means 1 plus 1, 2. Now in sum, 1 has stored. So 1 plus 2 is now here 3. Okay. Now again, we go for condition. 2 is equals to 10. No, 2 is not equals to 10. Then n is equals to n plus 1. Now 2 plus 1, 3. Now sum is equals to sum plus n. Earlier sum is 3. So 3 plus 3 is now 6. Now condition will check. Okay. 3 is equals to 10. 4 is equals to 10. No. Then 6 plus 4, 10. Then now n becomes what? 5. Okay. Then this process will continue. Okay. Now, last one, 10 is equals to 10. Yes. When yes, then display total sum. Total sum is 55. So, when you add from 1 to 10, the total number is 55, then it shows the result. Clear? Okay. Okay, so you do the homework that I have given. Okay, so after doing it, send me in the WhatsApp. Okay, tomorrow you are free at 9:30.
Morning 9:30. Yes, sir.
Okay, so tomorrow also I'll take at 9:30 morning. Okay.
Okay, sir.
चलो बाय
बाय सर.